I'm very happy to see you here in Brussels, Mr. Vice President. And the situation in Ukraine is getting worse every day. As close friends and partners, the European Union and the United States need to continue standing shoulder to shoulder, coordinate our efforts and uphold the pressure on Russia for as long as necessary. We cannot accept any form of aggression, especially the aggression of one state against another. We cannot compromise on Ukraine's independence, sovereignty, and territorial integrity. The horrendous attacks in Paris and the threat of more terrorist attacks will not intimidate us. Our determination to defend our values has only grown stronger. We need to intensify our counter-terrorism dialogue and continue to work closely together in addressing global threats, such as the one posed by ISIL. Finally, I want to call for both Europe and America to make all efforts to conclude the negotiations on a comprehensive and mutually beneficial transatlantic trade and investment partnership by the end of this year. I know this is ambitious, but the TTIP carries with it great potential in both economic and political terms. In all these areas, we have to resist any effort aimed at dividing the Western world. We need to tie our two continents even closer together, and the close friends and partners that we are.